Has this ever happened to you? You're working on your cool project and you go and build your Docker image and push it. And it just takes forever and goes on and on, and Docker takes its sweet time doing it. You might be building a resource intensive image, compiling lots of code, or just pushing a large image that your internet connection can't handle. Well, luckily, there is an easy fix for these issues. Docker lets us offload all those tasks to a remote server so our local machine doesn't have to do all the hard work. All this needs is Docker running on a remote server, and really a one-line configuration on the client. So let's set up the server. I'll go with the Docker image from the marketplace. This is an Ubuntu 18.04 image with Docker pre-installed. I wanted to have a decent amount of processing power, so I'll go with the CPU optimized plan, which provides dedicated hyperthreads. This one is fine. I'll go with Frankfurt. Make sure my SSH key is selected and create the droplet. The droplet is now created and we have a ready-to-use Docker server. But before we start using it, as a good security measure, we'll create a new user to use instead of root. So I'll copy the IP address. I'll go to my terminal and SSH into it as root. To create the user, I will run add user, I'll name it Sammy. Enter a password. These can be empty. And now it's created. Let's add it to the Docker group so we can give it access to the Docker engine running on the server. And I'll copy my SSH key to it so I can use it to SSH. And I'll change the ownership from root to the user so it can use the files. And that's it. Let's try to log in with it now. That works. Great. I'm back to my terminal on my local machine here, and all we need to do to use it is set the Docker host environment variable. So I'll set it to SSH:Sammy at my droplet's IP address. And now every Docker command I run will be actually run on the host. And to verify, we can run docker info, and you will see the name of the Docker host is my droplet's host name and not my laptop's host name. Okay, so let's try to build our image again and see how it goes now. So it's pulling the Go image, which I already had cached on my computer, but once that's done, it will be an apples to apples comparison. So it built the image fairly quickly and now it's pushing it. And you can see it uploading the layers much faster than on my computer. This is because the droplet's upload speeds are much, much better than my internet connection. And there you go. Just like that, we set up a remote Docker server that we can use to save our laptops from overheating. One thing to note is that when you run Docker build, the build context, which is all of the files and folders accessible from the Docker file, will be sent to the host, and then the build process will be run. So depending on your build context and the amount of files, it may take a longer time to build compared to your local machine, so you'll have to find the right balance there. One solution would be to create a new directory that is dedicated to the Docker image, and copy or link only the files that will be used in the image, so that no unneeded files will be uploaded to the Docker host, slowing down your process. Also, once you've set the Docker host variable using export, its value will persist until you close your shell. Or you can unset it by running export docker host and just setting it to an empty string. And once I clear it, I will go back to using my local Docker host.